Imagine a customer paying you 1 lakh for a product that you hadn't even made yet. You'd have to have a pretty good track record, right? But what if you didn't? What if you didn't have any track record? If you'd never made a physical product before? Well, this is exactly what happened in the case of Ola Electric, a company that drummed up so much hype, so much anticipation around their S1 and S1 Pro electric scooters that 1 lakh people bought them in the first 2 days of their online launch, that it provided Ola Electric with 1,100 crore rupees in revenue. But this hype would end up backfiring catastrophically for Ola Electric, because once they stopped being able to fulfill the promises that they were making to their customers, people would start looking for someone to blame. Some pointed at the company's management, others at the ambitious deadline set by Bhavish Aggarwal himself. But the reality of the situation actually goes much deeper than this, and it's what we're going to be talking about in today's video, coming up right after this. So Bhavish Aggarwal started Ola in 2010. And for the first decade or so of the startup's operations, they were a loss-making company. And they didn't enter the black until the financial year of 2021, when they finally brought in 90 crore rupees in profit. Now, this is surprising because by 2017, India's cab market had reached its saturation point in terms of growth. And commenting on this, one of Ola's executives said that the cab hailing business is finite. If you put together Ola and Uber, they're at, say, 100, and the market opportunity is 120. So the headroom to grow in the core business is not very high. So with that in mind, Ola's efforts to diversify their business make a lot of sense. They tried to get into food delivery, grocery delivery, financial services, selling used cars, and they even started a pizza brand. But none of these initiatives took off the way that Ola hoped they would. At least not until Ola Electric, anyways. Now, the mission of Ola Electric was both simple and extremely ambitious: start an EV revolution in India. The company dabbled in setting up charging stations, introducing Ola-branded EVs to their fleet like the Kinetic Safar Smart, Mahindra's E2O Plus, and Goldstone BYD buses, but it wasn't until May of 2020, when Ola acquired Amsterdam-based electric scooter startup Etergo, that Indian consumers started to get excited. But at this point, Ola Electric didn't really realize what they were getting themselves into. See, Ola Electric's initial plan was to take Etergo's AppScooter, make some minor modifications and tweaks, and then launch it in India. Simple. But of course, AppScooters were designed for the Netherlands, a country that's known for having some of the best roads in the world. And they also have some pretty cold weather over there too, with an average summer high between 20 and 25 degrees Celsius. India, in contrast, is a fairly hot country, especially during the summer. But you've also got to factor in light to heavy flooding in some cities too, as well as significantly more challenging road conditions. In Bengaluru, for example, the city where Ola Electric is headquartered, deep potholes can make driving scooters dangerous, especially during monsoon when those holes are hidden beneath puddles. Now, don't get me wrong here, I'm not saying that all of the roads in India are bad. There are tons of extremely well-maintained roads in India, and several of them I've had the pleasure of driving on myself. But when it comes to bad roads, they can be really, really bad. And so this was one of the factors that forced Ola Electric to redesign Etergo's app scooter to meet the unique needs of Indian roads and Indian conditions in general. And they only gave themselves 1 year to do it. Of course, Ola had never worked with hardware so extensively before. The startup was primarily a software company, and while their acqui-hire of Etergo staff did give them access to some very talented hardware engineers, these foreign engineers had a knowledge gap when it came to India. And so Ola's first task was filling this gap. Now, modifying the app scooter would end up involving the overhaul of the engines, the batteries, and the software, all of which were extremely complicated and challenging. And according to one former Ola Electric executive, these are not Lego blocks. When you try to put them together, there will be problems. Parts were not matching each other. There was manual rework of some of the parts, manual grinding and cutting of the parts to fit it together. Then, of course, once all of the modifications had been made, Ola Electric needed to figure out how to manufacture these scooters at scale. And they didn't have any factories. And I need to reiterate here that Ola had given themselves exactly 1 year to do all of this. And while most people, upon realizing how monumental a task getting these scooters out in a year was gonna be, would have extended the timeline, Bhavish Aggarwal was adamant that the team at Ola Electric had 1 year and not a day more. He wanted to bring this EV revolution to India, and he wanted to do it right away. Now, Bhavish Aggarwal is a resourceful and ambitious person. That's how he's managed to come so far as an entrepreneur. He knew that there would be challenges, that he and his employees would need to bend over backwards to make this thing work. But that's what building startups makes you good at. No obstacle is too big to overcome. And so as soon as he and his team were able to settle on a game plan, a roadmap for how they were gonna proceed with all of this, then Ola Electric went on a massive hiring spree. They were gonna hire 2,000 people from around the world, with more than 1,000 of them being engineers. And the idea here was to solve all of the problems that Ola Electric would inevitably face, like the software and the scooters, the vehicle's mismatched design, and the battery technology. They were gonna build a state-of-the-art flagship electric scooter, and for this, they would need a state-of-the-art facility. In December of 2020, Bhavish announced Ola Electric's plans to build the world's largest electric scooter factory, named the Futurefactory. Construction started in February of 2021 in Tamil Nadu, and the final capacity of this factory will be 10 million scooters per year, when the facility is running at peak capacity. Oh, and one other detail here is that once the factory is finished being built, its staff of 10,000 workers will be made up exclusively of women. On the 2nd of July of 2021, Bhavish Aggarwal shared a video of himself riding Ola electric scooters on the streets of Bengaluru. This created a ton of excitement, both for Indian EV enthusiasts and also just for regular everyday people. The hype grew so intense that when Ola opened up pre-bookings for these electric scooters on the 15th of July, more than 1 lakh people reserved a scooter. And keep in mind too here that there were no specs available at this time. The scooter's top speed, its range, its charging time were all unknown. But in spite of this, people chose to put their faith and trust in a company that had no track record when it came to making vehicles. Then, exactly 1 month later on the 15th of August, the scooters were officially launched as 2 variants, the S1 and the S1 Pro. And much to everybody's delight, the specs of these scooters didn't disappoint. The standard Ola S1 was listed as having a top speed of 90 kilometers per hour and a range of 121 kilometers. And the Ola S1 Pro was listed as having a top speed of 115 kilometers per hour and a range of 181 kilometers. And besides this, the scooters had some really cool software features too, like hill hold, cruise control, and remote unlocking, among others. So at this stage, everything seemed to be going well. Bhavish's insistence on a 1-year timeframe had ensured that Ola Electric moved with a speed and efficiency rarely seen in startups of their size. They built a world-class electric scooter and a world-class facility to bring these scooters into production. But then the bad news started rolling in. From the 8th of September of 2021, Ola pushed the booking date to the 15th of September. They said that they were still fixing some glitches on their website to ensure a smooth buying experience for their customers. Unfortunately, what was actually going on behind the scenes was significantly more dire. But they did end up sticking to that September 15th booking date and again, broke records with the number of scooters that they sold. They brought in revenue totaling 1,100 crore rupees in just 2 days. And it's estimated that they sold 1 lakh scooters in this time frame. And this is a pretty mind-blowing number because the number of electric two-wheelers, that's bikes and scooters, sold in India in 2021 was estimated to be around 1.36 lakh units. This means that Ola had, at least on paper, almost doubled the number of electric two-wheelers in India. Now, at the time of booking, Ola Electric had promised to start delivering these electric scooters between the 25th of October and the 25th of November, 2021. But this month-long period came and went and no scooters were delivered. And remember, people had already paid for these scooters. They felt that they were owed to them. Ola Electric basically had a massive unpaid debt on their hands now, and their lenders were growing impatient. People started taking to Twitter to voice their distrust in the company, and Ola responded by apologizing, saying that the delay had been caused by shortages of chipsets and electronic parts, but people found this hard to believe. Ola would have factored these shortages into their plans, as every automotive company had been facing similar issues since the beginning of the pandemic. No, something else was definitely going on here. Ola wasn't being honest or transparent with the customers that had given them their money. Finally, on the 15th of December of 2021, after multiple delays, Ola Electric started delivering their electric scooters. And that's when things went from bad to worse. See, remember that launch video where Bhavish was proudly talking about the Ola S1 Pro's 181 kilometer range? Well, that was really off base. In reality, the scooter's true range was just 135 kilometers, and the official advertised range that was listed as 181 kilometers was just an ideal range, tested in a controlled lab environment that was very different from the actual roads of India. Oh, and those cool software features that I mentioned earlier, hill hold, cruise control, remote unlocking, well, customers were gonna have to wait another 6 months to be able to use them. Then multiple reports of battery overheating started coming in, and complaints from customers about receiving damaged scooters as well. Angry customers started flooding the internet with complaints and criticism. And then the worst news of all came through. Ola announced that they would be halting the production of the standard Ola S1 scooters until late 2022, and would only be selling S1 Pro scooters instead. So this is the point in the story where we need to stop and ask a very important question. What happened? Well, to start off with, the time frame was unrealistic. Expecting Ola Electric to reinvent Etergo's app scooter, build the Futurefactory, and get scooters out the door in a year's time just wasn't a smart move, and resulted in corner cutting and a product that looked great on paper and in photographs and videos, but didn't perform anywhere near as well as promised. Things were exasperated further by many of Ola Electric's top executives leaving in the middle of all of this. Just a few months after Ola Electric had acquired Etergo, in August of 2020, Ola Electric's co-founder Ankit Jain left the company, but he wasn't the first. Two people who had been heading battery engineering had also walked away from Ola Electric, and then Sanjay Bun, an auto industry veteran and Ola Electric's chief business officer, left in July of 2020. Then, later on in November of 2021, quality assurance head Joseph Thomas was fired. And these are just a handful of a large number of people that Ola Electric lost along the path that they took to creating the S1 and S1 Pro electric scooters. According to one former executive, most of the engineers working on these scooters in the early days eventually left the company. And when senior people left too, the burden fell on the shoulders of junior employees, the people who are least equipped to carry it. Then there was the problem of Ola Electric's messy supply chain. There are people who have not engineered the product from the testing stage. Supply chains have been asked to deliver the parts. The quality team is forced to accept rejected parts to continue with deliveries. There's a three-way tug of war, which is creating chaos. Another detail that has come to light is how undercooked the scooter software was when they were launched. Another former executive said that, "I was literally shocked when I heard about the vehicle launch because most of the software modules weren't completely developed and tested." Lots of bugs were reported at initial testing itself. In short, Ola Electric has suffered from a very common, yet very complicated problem to fix: crunch. See, crunch is something that can be easily eliminated by extending the timeline. If prior to the scooter's launch, upon realizing that the timeline wasn't realistic, Bhavish had simply given the team another 6 months, then all of these issues would have likely been resolved. Many key people probably would have stuck around, feeling that the company wasn't about to crash and burn thanks to an extended, comfortable runway. Instead though, for better or for worse, Bhavish stuck to the original plan. There was no extension, no adaptation, just a rigid fixed timeline that forced employees to cut corners, rush things that shouldn't have been rushed, and ultimately they and Ola Electric's customers paid the price for this by suffering delays, scratches and dents, a lack of software functionality, and in one case, the customer's scooter actually caught fire. And now the government of India is investigating the incident to find out why this happened, as the S1 and S1 Pro were both tested and received government approvals before being launched into the market. Now, initially, we here at Backstage with Millionaires were on board with Ola Electric's vision of bringing an EV revolution to India. I mean, this is the thumbnail of the 78th news episode that we posted, and we still want to see that revolution come to India in some form or another, but we're just not sure if Ola Electric are going to be the ones to bring it. I'm starting to wonder if the S1 and S1 Pro were, in fact, a revolution, or if they were just a jugaad, something that Ola had haphazardly hacked together in a desperate attempt to stay relevant and growing as a company. And I'm curious to know what your thoughts are on this. Are the S1 and S1 Pro and future products that Ola Electric makes, for example, an electric car, perhaps in 2023, are they going to be a revolution for India's EV space, or is Ola Electric already dead and they just don't realize it yet? Leave your thoughts in a comment down below, and thank you guys so much for watching this episode of Backstage with Millionaires. I'll see you in the next one.